Hello, my name is John from Liquid Web. Today, I'm going to show you how to get started with Flask. Flask is a Python microframework designed to be lightweight and offering you the freedom to create web applications without limitations on the modules and packages you want to use and the methods and structures you want to follow. For this tutorial, I will be showing you how to build a Flask web application. Building your Flask applications locally first will allow you to build and test prior to moving to a production or development server, and it also gives you a good sandbox for learning. First, you will need to have Python 3 and pip 3 installed. We will be building this inside of a virtual environment, so virtualenv will need to be installed as well. If you do not have it already, virtualenv can be installed by running pip 3 install virtualenv in your terminal. Now let's get started. All of the work demonstrated in this tutorial will be done inside of a terminal. These instructions are intended for macOS or Linux-based operating systems. First, we will want to create a virtual environment to build the application inside of. Now we're going to run the following command to create the Python virtual environment. So in this command, the Python equals Python 3 argument is used to describe what Python interpreter we're going to use for the virtual env. And the flask underscore tutorial is what the name of the virtual environment is going to be. Now we're going to let that run. And what this is going to do is create a directory named flask underscore tutorial. And that is going to be at the path at which you're currently at. So we can see here that the flask underscore tutorial directory has been created. We'll want to change directories into that directory and activate that virtual environment. To activate the virtual environment, we'll need to run the command source, bin slash activate, and that's going to activate our virtual environment, and you can see that it's activated. Now that the virtual environment is activated, let's install the flask package. We're going to do this with pip. Now that Flask has been installed, let's get started with building a Flask web application. I will be using Vim as my text editor, but any text editor will work for this. I'll begin by opening a new file with Vim. At the top of this file, we'll want to import the Flask package. Now we need to set up Flask by creating a variable app and set that equal to flask. And we'll need to pass in name. We are now ready to create our first route. Routes in Flask use a decorator to define the route. Once the route is defined, below that we will create a function that is executed when the route is hit. For this, we will be defining one route, which is the root of the website. When the root of the website is navigated to in a browser, the function created below will be processed. And the slash here is indicating the root of the website. And since we're creating this as the root of the website, I'm just going to call this function index. And we're just going to return a simple h1 element. And now that the route has been created, we need to add an if statement to check if this is the main package on execution. If the condition is true, run the Flask development web server. That is all we need in the file to run a basic Flask web application. Now save and exit, and let's run the application. To start the development server and start our Flask application, type the following command. You can see the development server is now running and is showing what it's running on. This is what you will need to navigate to it in a browser to see the web application. For me, you can see the application is running on 127.0.0.1 over port 5000. So if we go to that in a browser, we'll be able to see the Python web application. You can see in the terminal when going to the address, the request and response codes are listed as they come in. We made a request for slash, and can see that returned a 200. There's also a request for favicon.ico. That returned a 404 as it does not exist. This request was generated by Chrome. That is all for now. We have successfully created a Flask web application. From here, you can build on this and create powerful web applications. As always, thank you for watching this video. For more information and articles, be sure to visit liquidweb.com/KB.